To the left of this junction, we will see the acceptor ions will be there. Okay, these are uncompensated because the holes have already moved towards N side, and towards the N side, the acceptor ions are donor ions are uncompensated. So these are positively charged. Okay, and I think I should only show it like this. Okay, all right. Let us say that this length is the penetration towards P side is xp, because we are considering x equal to 0 here, and this is our x equal to xn. Okay, so the penetration towards P side is xp and towards N side is xn. Okay, the doping level in the P region was Na, and towards the N region was Nd, and this region is basically the neutral P region. Okay, and this one is neutral N region. Alright, and under thermal equilibrium, when there is no external excitation, the Fermi level has to be constant. Okay, so that's why we will draw it here like this, EF. Okay, and this side, the neutral P side actually. Okay, so neutral P side, the EF will be closer to EV. Okay, so that's why I have drawn here EV. Okay, and the EC will be somewhere here, the conduction energy level. Okay, because this is P side. So in P side, basically the Fermi level will be close to EV, because there are acceptor high acceptor concentration here towards the P side. Okay, and on the same argument, we can also draw the energy band diagram towards the neutral N side. Okay, so again here the EC level will be close to EF, because it is a neutral N region. Okay, so this is EC, and below EG there will be EV. Okay, and this is again, this gap is EG here, here to the energy total band gap. Okay, and the same band gap is also here. Okay, then we discussed that because of this electric field, and the electric field is pointed towards it will be from right to left. Okay, because of the specific presence of this acceptor as well as the donor ions. Okay, and this electric field will actually cause the, if you are concerned about the electronic energy, so electronic energy will drop towards it will drop actually when someone moves from left to right. Okay, so this EC is actually continuously decrease. Okay, and it will bend like this. Okay, this bending is, as you know, is because of the presence of electric field. Okay, and this EV level will also follow this EC level exactly in the same way, so that the band gap will remain constant throughout the material. Okay, now you can see, let us draw this metallurgical junction reference here, even in the energy band diagram. Okay, and one energy level is left, that is intrinsic Fermi level. So intrinsic Fermi level will always be in the middle of the Farbian gap. So let us also draw that. Okay, so EI is going to be like this. It will be exactly in the middle of Farbian gap. Okay, and it will also follow here the bands. Okay, and it goes like this. Okay, this is EI. Alright, so now let us, till this point we had discussed in the previous class. Okay, this is minus xp position, x equal to minus xp, this is x equal to xn. Okay, so in N region basically the electrons are in majority, so let us call it NN, and the hole are basically PN. Okay, similarly in the P region the holes are in majority PP and the electrons are in minority NP. Okay, and in neutral N region, you know that the electronic concentration is high, so NN is equal to ND. Okay, and the PN can be given as Ni square by Nd. Similarly, in neutral P region, the whole concentration will be equal to Na, PP is equal to Na, and Np will be equal to Ni square by Na. Okay, and in neutral N region, as the electronic concentration is very high, so you can see that the EC level here is close to EF. Okay, as we have already discussed. Okay, and this will remain close till the edge of depletion region. Okay, why it is so? Because in the depletion region, you can see that the electrons of this N side have already migrated, they have already moved towards the P side. So electronic concentration is less to the in this particular portion of the depletion region. Okay, so if electronic concentration is less, means ES has to move away from the EF. Okay, because larger this gap EC minus EF refers to smaller electronic concentration. Okay, so as someone move from this line in this direction, you will see that EC is going away from EF, and it is indicating that the whole concentration, the electron concentration, is actually decreasing in this particular half of depletion region. Okay, so that's why this band is moving up, EC is moving up, it is going away from EF, and this gap keeps on increasing. Okay, what will be the nature of the material at the junction? It will be p-type or n-type? Any one of you, can you comment?
N-type.
N-type. Sure. Just look at the energy band diagram.
Okay. Intrinsic, sir.
It is actually when someone moving from this line towards the junction, metallurgical junction, it will be electronic concentration will be decreasing, it is decreasing, and at the junction it becomes intrinsic. Okay, because the EF minus EI is zero, as you can see, or you can see that EC minus EF is EG by 2. Okay, so at the junction, at this particular point, the EC minus EF is actually EG by 2. Okay, or you can also say that since EI minus EF is equal to 0, so N is Ni, because N equal to Ni e to the power EF minus EI by KT. So EF minus EI 0, so N is equal to Ni. And similarly, the whole concentration is equal to Ni. So at the junction, it is just intrinsic, you can say. Okay, and similar argument can also be made. Okay, from P side, you can see the whole concentration is here higher. Therefore, the EV is very close to the Fermi level EF in the neutral region. And at the edge of depletion region, from P side, okay, the EV has started moving away from this EF, and this is the indication that now this region is less p-type. It is still p-type, but you can call it less p-type because the whole concentration is decreasing. Okay, it's a whole decreasing, and at this point it becomes intrinsic, almost intrinsic. Okay, so the energy band diagram says it contains a lot of information. If you carefully examine it, you can get many important facts which could be useful for further analysis of the device. Okay, that's why I took this once again. Okay, And if you recall, when we are talking about the band bending, okay, there I told you that if you reverse the shape of the energy level, EC level or EI level or EF level, you will get the potential variation, because V equal to minus 1 upon Q EC minus E reference. Am I right? V equal to minus 1 by Q EC minus E reference. Okay. So, if you'd like to know how the potential will look like, basically you can just reverse the shape of this EC, okay, and you can get the potential variation in the depletion region. So, it will be something like this. Okay. And let us say that this difference is, the potential difference is VVI, the built-in voltage. Okay, let us call it built-in voltage VVI. Okay, so if this is a built-in voltage VVI, then this can be also placed on this energy band diagram. This is nothing but Q time VVI. This gap will be equal to Q time VVI. Am I right? Because this, the y-axis in this energy band diagram is in energy, okay? And this is actually the potential variation, V. Okay, I am not commenting what is the absolute potential in neutral P region and N region, okay? But if the two sides of P and N are actually connected to ground, then we can assume that the potential is zero in these two regions, okay? But let us not go into that. Actually, our prime interest here is this potential barrier. Okay, so here we see there is a potential barrier. Okay, now this potential barrier is potential barrier, or you can call this energy barrier. Okay, there is an energy barrier. So if there is a electron present here, okay, just at the edge of this, let's say at this particular point, okay, it can move easily in this direction, all right, because of this electric field. But what will happen to the electrons that are here? Okay, you see that this is neutral N region, okay, and in neutral N region there are plenty of electrons, lot of electrons, N is equal to ND, okay. And let us say that the electronic concentration is shown like this, okay, because you know that at higher energy the electronic concentration goes down, okay. So electronic concentration is higher at the near the edge of the EC, and when we go upward the electronic concentration is decreasing here, okay. So there are lot of holes, electrons in this N region. And similarly, there will be a lot of electrons in the P region, a lot of holes in the P region. Okay. So these are holes because this is a neutral P region. So in neutral P region, the holes are in majority. Neutral N region, electrons are in majority. Okay. So these electrons of this N region will actually see an energy barrier. They cannot move, they cannot surmount this barrier in this direction, okay, if this barrier height is significant and if the energy Q time VVI is actually much greater, or it's greater than this energy level. So from the it is very easy to predict that these carriers, the carriers which are present here, the electrons in this neutral N region, they will be actually, they will be facing an energy barrier here, and if they will have energy greater than this barrier, then only they can cross this barrier and they can go to the N region. This actually I am talking once the equilibrium has been established, okay.
So for the electrons which are returning due to electric field created due to the remaining charges, right? For the electrons returning due to the electric field created in the width, that
No, no, no. Actually, I am talking about the things after equilibrium. During equilibrium, these things will happen. There will be carriers will be moving from one direction to another direction. There will be drift, and in response to drift, there will be diffusion, and to counter that, there will be drift tendency. Both will cancel to each other, and once after that, equilibrium is established. And once equilibrium is established, then there is no further increment in the width of the depletion region. Okay, I am just talking about after once the situation, once equilibrium has been established. Once the equilibrium has been established, then the majority carriers of this N side, they will face an energy barrier. Okay, and this energy barrier will further prevent them to move from N side to P side. And similarly, the holes from P side, these holes, they are also seeing an energy barrier, which is again Q time VVI. Okay, this energy barrier, and this energy barrier will prevent them moving from P side to N side. Okay, so this energy barrier will actually won't allow the carriers to move from one side to another side, and therefore there will not be any current in the equilibrium. Okay. So current can set up only when the equilibrium is disturbed. Okay. Is it okay to everybody?
Sir.
Yes.
Isn't it like the positive charge will be balanced by the electron carrier on the inside?
Talking about the depletion region charges?
Yes sir.
Yeah, they will be balanced because there must be charge neutrality in the device always. Okay, charges must be balanced, positive charges must be balanced by the negative charges. Okay, so I am coming to that actually. I am just considering.
No, sir, I am saying that the edge side of the electrons will be shifted to the depletion region, and the depletion region would speed to the extent of
now they will not shift. Now how can they shift? Because of this potential barrier, actually they won't move from this N region. They won't leave this N region, and even you will see that in this depletion region, actually there is a carrier concentration, but that is small. And this potential barrier is actually there. This potential barrier will stop the further movement of the carriers, okay, through the junction.
All right. So, sir, it's like N region, P region, and in between there is intrinsic region.
Which one?
Depletion region, we can say, or intrinsic region?
Not exactly. Depletion means the depletion region. Okay. Depletion region, you just keep in this mind, it means that the concentration of the mobile carriers are less. Okay. Concentration of mobile carrier is less. Okay. And I mean this less means the carrier concentration must be lesser than the doping level of this P region and N region. For example, in P region, the doping level is Na. So the whole concentration in this side of the depletion region must be less than Na. Okay. And similarly, the concentration of this electron in this depletion region is less than that of Na. So that if there are situation like P plus N P minus N plus ND. ND is positive, ND minus NA. Okay, so we could neglect, if let's say that we are talking about this particular side of the depletion region. Okay, so in this region, we can neglect the whole concentration as well as electron concentration, and we can say that this NA is greater than ND. So the total charge density in this region is actually equal to ND. Okay. So concentration, mobile carrier concentration is less. but this depletion approximation is used to determine the potential distribution. Okay, considering that the carrier concentration is zero. Okay, so although there will be carrier concentration in the depletion region, mobile carrier concentration, but that can be negligible compared to the fixed acceptor ions or donor ions of that particular side of the depletion region.
Sir, can you repeat how it became ND?
Other than ND, each and other terms are, the total charge is what? The total positive charge minus total negative charge. Whole positive charge, N electron negative charge, ND donor density and Na acceptor density. Let us say that all are present everywhere. Okay, so I was just talking about the left side of this depletion region. So in the left side of depletion region, this is P region. Okay, this is P type. So if it is P type, means Na is large. Okay, because P type dope means the acceptor doping concentration is going to be large. And the other components, the whole concentration is smaller than Na, electronic concentration is also smaller than Na, and even the donor density must be smaller than Na. So all these three terms together, even less than this. So that's why I can consider safely that in this region, the charge density is Na, the magnitude of the charge density is Na.
Yes, sir, it is Na and you wrote ND. So I
got... Okay, I'm sorry. Where I have written? I was just
Where your cursor is.
No, this was Na. This is ND. Okay, so Na greater than ND. Okay.
Alright.
So this is Na actually. Okay. And similarly, you can go to the even similar assumption you can make for the depletion region of the P side. So N side. So there actually the total charge density will be ND. Okay. This side it is ND. This side it is Na. But please understand that this is an approximation. Okay. In reality, the carriers will be there. If the carrier concentration is zero, that will theoretically leads to the infinite current, because there will be a concentration gradient, huge concentration gradient. Okay. I mean, if there is a dN by dx, okay, if let's say this side, the electron concentration is very small, I mean zero, and this side it is very large. So dN by dx is actually very, very large, okay, and that will lead to a huge diffusion current. Okay, so it's not true. The although we are assuming here that the only charge is the donor ions in this case, but the electrons are also present. Okay, holes are also present, but their concentration is very small, and there is a gradual decrement of the carrier from the neutral N side towards the depletion side, and similarly from the neutral P side towards the depletion region. Okay, we'll see that when we'll derive the drain current expression, there we'll consider this fact. Okay, so all right, here actually now let us do the charge balancing from P side and P side depletion region and N side depletion region, and let us comment that is there any relation between the charge density and the depth of the depletion region. Okay, so to maintain the charge neutrality, you see that the total charge that are present in the P side of the depletion region must be equal to the total charge that are present in the N side of the depletion region. Okay, so the total charge that are present in the P side of the depletion region must be equal to how much? P side depletion region charge. What will be the total charge? Q equal to, any one of you?
Must PDN be plus ND minus NA.
Charge density Q into ND. This is total charge density, charges per centimeter cube multiplied by the volume. And if let's say that the A is the cross section area of this diode, okay, then it must be multiplied by Xn, okay, because Xn is the length of depletion region. You can see here Xn is the length of the depletion region towards the N side, okay. So here Q equal to Q ND A into Xn, okay. And similarly towards the P side, N side depletion charge. Similarly, P side depletion charge. Is the total charge Qn, let us write it Qp. So Qp is similarly Q time Na minus Q time Na into A into Xp. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
And the total charge from P side must be equal to the charge of N side. Okay, so Qn must be equal to mod of Qp. And therefore, Qnd AXN must be equal to QNA AXP. AQ are cancelled out. Okay, so NAXN equal to, sorry, the both side I have taken ND, sorry, NDXN, NDXN is equal to NAXP. Okay. And therefore, I can write Xn upon Xp is equal to Na upon Nd. Okay. Is it okay, all of you? All right. So, if the N side, if the P side is having higher doping than the N side, okay. So you can see that the depletion region will be penetrated more towards N side compared to P side. Is it or not? If Na is greater than NP, Na is greater than ND, acceptor concentration P side is greater than the donor concentration of the N side. So Xn is going to be greater than Xp. What is Xn? The depth of depletion region towards N side. Okay. So the side which is having higher doping will push the depletion region towards the other side. Okay. So if I have very, very high doping towards the P side and very less towards the N side, means let's say that the order of doping is 100 times greater, okay. If Na is at least 100 times greater than that of Nd, so in that case the Xn will be much larger than Xp, and even in the analysis we can neglect Xp compared to Xn, okay. And then we call the junction to be one-sided junction. And that junction is noted as P plus N junction, okay. P plus means P side is having higher doping than the N side. So in one sided the total depletion width W, if it is Xn plus Xp, okay. So in P plus N junction, we can say that W is equal to Xn, because then we can draw, we can neglect Xp compared to Xn. Because since the P side is having higher doping, it will push the depletion region towards the N side. And similarly case for NP plus kind of junction. Okay. So in NP plus kind of junction, the W could be approximated as, sorry, it's N plus P. Okay. So W could be, can be approximated as XP in this case. Okay, so these are one-sided junction, and these junctions are relevant when we talk about the other devices like MOSFETs. Okay, but if you keep this fact in your mind, then you will be able to simplify the relations that will develop here to use in those context. Okay. So now if we plot the charge density here, if I take charge density at x yeah.
Up to what ratio of Na by Nd or Nd by Na we can say that this is major? Like
if Na is, let's say, greater than 100, then Nd, okay, then we can say it's a one-sided transition. Or actually there is nothing, it's not somewhere not defined like this, okay. Generally in practical cases like MOSFET, the N side has the doping 10 to the power 20 per centimeter cube, whereas the P side will have doping like 10 to the power 17 or 16 or 15 sometime. Okay, so there we can consider that this is a one-sided junction. At least 1000 times you can see the difference. Okay. In a MOS transistor, the source region is N plus and the substrate is P type. Okay, so N plus P junction we see over there. And this is the typical value, 10 to the power 20 and 17, and we call it one-sided junction. Okay, so otherwise it will be mentioned. If it is mentioned N plus P or P plus N, you just consider it as a one-sided junction. This is an indication of one-sided junction. One side is heavily doped than the other side. Okay? Clear?
Okay, sir.
Yes, all right. So charge density graph we can plot. Okay. And here I am plotting charge density at y-axis and taking position at x-axis. Okay. So here the Nd is the charge density towards this P side, okay, towards N side. So, and we are consider that Na is slightly greater than Nd. So therefore, this is shown Nd is here, okay. This area is showing, this is actually the charge density Nd over X, okay. And Na will be like this. Na will be here because it's negative, so it's a minus Na. All right, it's a minus Na, and let's say that this is shown here. It will be spread till minus Xp, and this is going to spread over Xn. Okay, so I have shown here the height of this slightly greater than this height to indicate the fact that Na is slightly greater than Nd. Okay, if both are same, Na is equal to Nd, then the Xn will be equal to Xp. Okay, and in that case this will look this side and this side distribution will look identical. Okay, otherwise the side which will have higher doping will have narrower distribution. I mean the charge distribution will be there in a because the depletion width will be narrower. Okay, so it will have a higher value, higher density, and the smaller narrower depth of the depletion region. Okay, and if the side is having lower doping, then actually it will spread over the longer distance because the total charge has to be neutralized. Okay, as you have seen, it is Xp here, Xn into Nd is to be equal to Xp into Na. Okay, so if Nd is greater than Na, then the Xn will be narrower than Xp and vice versa. Okay, so in one-sided junction, however, the things will be like this. If it is one-sided N plus P junction, P plus N, let us say, P plus N junction, the charge distribution will look like this. It will be in a form of very thin sheet with very high density. Okay, and the other side will be like this. So this will go up to xn and this is minus xp. So xp is very small than xn. So this is a charge distribution for p plus n case. If you keep increasing p plus, this goes narrower and this height, the magnitude of the charge will go on increasing. Okay, it will further increase like this and this will increase like this. Okay, so this is for p plus n junction, the charge density versus position. Okay, clear till point, till this point? Any one of you, any question, any doubt, please feel free to ask. Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
So now we'll try to find out an equation for the built-in potential VBI, built-in potential or junction potential. Some text you will see it as a junction potential. Okay, or we can also call it built-in potential. Okay. So let us try to find out the built-in potential value. Okay. So here again we will refer to this energy band diagram. Okay. And the built-in potential VBI is actually related with the total bending in the energy. Okay. From this point to this point, the total bending. So that's why the energy level is referred as Q time VBI here. Okay. It's total bending. So we take EC level or EI level, it doesn't matter because EI will also follow this EC. So total bending in EC across the depletion region will be equal to the total bending in EI. Okay, so let us take this EI to calculate the built-in potential. So if we again see the total bending in EI, total bending is this, it will be again equal to Q time VBI. Okay, and we can find out this Q time VBI because we know the relation between EI and EF and the charge density, and similarly EF and EI and the charge density of this side. Okay, and we can use those relations to find out this VBI. So VBI is nothing but it is EI minus EF by Q from this side plus EF minus EI by Q of this side. Is it or not? Shall I draw it? Shall I draw a press picture or you are able to get it?
Yes, press picture. Huh? So draw fresh picture, okay. It's too much confusing.
Okay, so let me refer to the slide then. I think this is over there. Okay, so the built-in potential is total potential drop across the depletion region as it is shown here. Okay, and here actually it is shown how to find out the built-in potential. Okay, so you can see this is the neutral P side. This is the neutral P side. Okay, in neutral P side, the energy band diagram will look like P region, a P type semiconductor material. Okay, so what we are looking to find out, we are looking to find out this potential, the potential corresponding to this energy difference. And if you can also find out the potential corresponding to this energy difference, okay, we can sum these two potential and we can find out the total potential corresponding to this complete bending, okay, and we can get the built-in potential. Okay, so So potential here corresponding to this difference psi p is 1 upon q ei minus ef. Okay. Ei is this energy level, as you know, ei is intrinsic level and ef is the Fermi level. Okay. So psi p is basically the potential. Taking EF is taken as a reference here, so that's why the EF is subtracted, and therefore the psi p is minus 1 upon q into EI minus EF. Okay, please note that this is not an absolute potential at this particular point. This is actually the potential corresponding to this energy gap. Okay, EI minus EF. So psi p is 1 upon q EI minus EF. P is already known because this region is a P region, okay, neutral P region. So for neutral P region, we can say that the P is Ni e to the power e minus ef by kT, okay, and we can put P equal to Na, P equal to Na, then this is Na equal to Ni e to the power ei minus ef by kT, okay. And from here, actually, EI minus EF by KT can be substituted in this relation because EI minus EF is actually KT into natural log of NA upon NI. Okay, so this can be substituted in this relation, and therefore the psi p becomes minus KT by Q into natural log of NA upon NI. Okay. Is it clear? So this psi p, this gap is basically, this potential difference is related with the doping level of that particular site. For the p site, it is kT by q is in volt, okay. Room temperature, it will be around 25 millivolt, natural log of Na upon Ni. Larger the Na, this EF will be far away from EI. Okay, so that's why the psi p will be larger in that case, because if the doping level Na is large, it means it is a strongly p type, and in p type EF will be closer to EV. Okay, so that's why this psi p is calculated, which is kT by q natural log of Na upon Ni. Okay, and similarly we can also find out EF minus EI from this N side, okay. From this N side, you can again write psi n equal to minus 1 upon q EF minus EI, okay. And because here it was EI minus EF, and in case of psi n, it is minus 1 upon q EF minus EI, because EF is at higher energy than the EI, okay. Just to take care of the sign. And then similar equation can be written for electrons, n equal to ni e to the power ef minus ei by kT, and then we can solve that and we will reach to this conclusion that psi n is kT by q natural log of nd upon ni. Now the total built-in potential is psi n minus psi p, okay, this minus this. If you look at the only magnitude, then it will be psi n plus mod of psi p, okay. So that is actually VBI, and psi n is as you can see kT by q log nd upon ni, psi p is kT by q log na upon ni. So VBI is kT by q natural log of nd upon ni plus kT by q log na upon ni, and that's why it is kT by q natural log of na nd upon ni square. Okay, so this is the equation for built-in voltage. Okay, if you see it from the energy band diagram perspective, then this, the built-in potential is the main region is the difference in the work function of the two sides. Okay, here is P site, okay. For P site, this is EC, EV, EI in the middle and EF is here. Okay, for N side, this is EC. EC, EV, EI and EF. EF is here. If we take vacuum level as a reference, okay, so the work function for this material, N side will be this, and the work function for this is this, this is EI actually. Okay, so Q time EF here for N side is you can say smaller than Q time EF for the P side in magnitude. Okay. And the work function here is larger from P towards the P side, smaller towards the N side. When the two materials are brought in close contact, irrespective of their P region, N region, or both are metal, or one is metal, one is semiconductor, there will always be a built-in potential formed if there is a difference in their respective work function. If the work function of the two materials are same, okay, then no no electrical junction will be formed. There will not be any depletion region. There will not be any built-in voltage at the junction. But if there is a potential difference between the two region, if there is a difference in the work function of the two region, there will always be a depletion region at the junction. In that case, carrier will be moving from higher energy side to the lower energy side, because in this case you can see that this is the N region, electrons are in plenty here, so they are at the higher energy than the electron of this side, because the Fermi level here is low, okay, and therefore the electrons will be moving from this side to this side, and this side becomes positive because electrons have left this side and they have reached this side, so this side becomes negatively charged. Okay. Similar argument can also be made for the holes. Okay, so if there are their work functions are not same, okay, let's say that this side work function is given as a phi w1, this side it is given as a phi wt2. So if phi w1 is not same as a phi wt, there will be a depletion region and there will be a built-in potential. And the built-in potential is nothing but the difference, it will be related with the difference in the these two. Okay, it will be basically phi w1 minus phi w2 divided by q. Okay, so from this actually argument 2, okay, if you try to find out the built-in potential, if you try to find out their respective work function, okay, and then subtract the work function of this region from this side, you will again get the same difference, kt by q log na nd upon ni square, which is actually the built-in voltage. Okay, so okay, so that you can also check. Okay, you can take two metals. One is having, let's say, work function 4.3 electron volt, another one having work function of 4.7 electron volt. Okay, and you can see that the built-in potential will be actually 4.7 minus 4.3, so it is 0.4 volt.
4.3
Is it okay? Any question, any doubt from anybody? No question. Fine. No, if Na equal to Nd, there will be VBI. Why there won't be? There will be VBI. Okay, if their work functions are same, okay. Work function same means if both are P region and with same doping, then there will no VBI. If both are P site, if even their both are P region, but their work function are different, their doping levels are different, then there may be VBI. If both are N region and there is a difference in doping level, then their work function will differ. So there will be VBI. Okay, it is not necessary that if there is only P and N, then only there will be VBI. Okay, but if there is one P and another N and they are having same doping level, Na equal to Nd, then again there will be VBI. Got it? Dasarath Kumar? Okay. So, even if you make a junction of two metals, okay, and the metals are not same, their work function are different. For example, you are making a contact of gold and nickel, okay, or gold or platinum. So there will be VBI at the junction, okay, because their work functions are different. Okay. So this is one way of calculating the built-in potential. You can try another way. There could be there are other ways as well. Okay, just I am giving one hint to you here. There is another way here. So in thermal equilibrium, the Jp and Jn are equal to zero. So you can put Jp equal to zero here. Okay, in this equation. Jp equal to 0, so q time mu p p e equal to q dp dp by dx. Okay, e as you know is minus del psi by dx, del psi by del x. Okay, and this is q dp and dp by dx. Okay, so this can be q cancelled out, mu p upon dp. Okay, what is mu p upon dp? Any one of you?
Q by KT by Q.
KT by Q. Thermal voltage. Okay. Dp upon mu p is KT by Q. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, you can actually write it like this. And dx dx cancel out. You can integrate it d psi from this side, d psi can be from psi p to psi n, okay, p side to n side, and d psi minus d psi, this dp upon mu p is vt, you can kt by q you can place here, and this side is dp is the whole concentration varying from p side to n side. So from p side the whole concentration is pp. And from N side it is Pn. Okay. Or something is missing actually. Q mu p. P is missed, na? P. So P will go to the right hand side. So it is dp by P. Dp by P. Okay. 1 by P will come over here. Okay. So dp by P is log of P. Okay. And limit will be from Pn to Pp. And d psi is psi n minus psi p, so which is V naught, built-in voltage. And then you can put kT by q, can be placed this side. And you can put the limit of the doping level. Pn equal to pp equal to na and pn equal to ni square upon nd. You will get the same relation. Built-in voltage as kT by q log n nd by ni square. Okay, so I will stop here today. We'll continue this next class. Okay, we'll discuss about the depletion width, electric field, okay, depletion capacitances, and then we'll talk about the IV characteristics. Thank you.